Mrs. H.E. Curry's daughter had recently married Mr. Charles Esterbrook, an attorney from Syracuse, New York, and good friend and attorney to H.A. Moyer. In 1904, Charles Esterbrook joined his brother, William Esterbrook, and established the law firm of Esterbrook Esterbrook. In 1946, the firm's name was changed to Esterbrook Esterbrook, Burns and Hancock. Due to a merger in 1969, the firm became Hancock Esterbrook, Ryan, Shove and Hust. In 1983, the firm's name changed yet again and was abbreviated to Hancock and Esterbrook. This prominent and successful law firm would represent the Moyer, Ward, and Forgan families to this very day, 98 years later. By 1907, Moyer's herd of Holstein Friesian cows, headed by his prize-winning bull, King Sieges, is just as successful as his carriages. One cow, Sieges AG, produces 32 pounds of butter on a weekly basis. It holds a world record, second only by one other cow, both of the same stock. Two rare shots inside the great barn at Moyerdale, showing the cow stanchions in the dairy. The same year of 1907 also brings the death of Maria E. Abbott Moyer, H.A. Moyer's mother. She is laid to rest next to her husband, Oliver Moyer, at the Pine Plains Cemetery in Clay, New York. This is an actual Moyer stock certificate. Keeping up with the times, Moyer realizes that the carriage would soon be obsolete due to the horseless carriage, so he builds his own. This is the 1908 Moyer experimental car. This 1908 set of encyclopedias, bought by H.A. Moyer in 1907, was a wonderful addition for his collection of books. That same year, he was given this pocket knife by his daughter, Maud Moyer Ward. These diamond cufflinks were also a proud possession of H.A. Moyer. During the past few years, Maud Moyer Ward has studied the art of interior decorating. This is her thimble, in which she used when she sewed curtains together. Also during this time, her interest in antiques begins. This is one of Ward Wellington Ward's personalized razor blades. There was a blade for each day of the week. Sadly, only two exist today. In 1908, the Wards decided to move back to Syracuse. At this time, Syracuse is growing by leaps and bounds and needs new architects. For the next 8 months, the Wards live with H.A. Moyer at his park in Danforth House. H.A. Moyer, who loves his daughter and son-in-law, wants to help them out any way he can, gives Ward an offer he can't refuse, to build his newly conceived automobile factory. Ward is overcome and very honored by this gesture. But first, Ward must complete other obligations of building homes already lined up for him, some even by his generous father-in-law. One of Ward's early houses in Syracuse is built in 1908 at 109 Concord Place for William A. Doubleday. Next, this house for the JF Group at 1205 Spring Street. Another design in 1908 at 508 Turtle Street for this two-family house for B.W. Fairchild. This is a 1909 Moyer carriage catalog. By this time, the carriages have become very elaborate, but with the original basic design. Here are Bert Moyer's children, Roseman, Harold, and Edward Moyer, outside the Moyer factory showroom in a Moyer custom-made basket pony cart. Their driver's name was Frank. Here are Bert Moyer's children again, this time sitting on the front porch of H.A. Moyer's Park and Danforth house. The Wards move into Moyerdale after H.A. Moyer gives Ward a generous offer of unlimited use of the house and property. For the next 8 years, the Wards use Moyerdale as their studio and home. Moving back to Syracuse has brought childhood friends back together again, Maud Moyer Ward and Helen Avery Noble. Their friendship would last for the rest of their lives. Ward's commissions keep coming in 1909, an automobile garage and showroom for James Corbett at 1641 East Genesee Street, now Richmark Carpet Company. A trip to Watertown for George H. Hooker at 252 Paddock Drive. Back in Syracuse, this house for Harry W. Parrott at 5408 South Salina Street. This is Ward's 50th commission. A two-family house for Mrs. Alton Simmons at 609 Euclid Avenue. This photo, taken June 14, 1909, shows the future site of H.A. Moyer's automobile factory before the buildings on the site are torn down and auto factory built. The Syracuse building permit was filed in 1908, the previous year. This photo was taken September 14, 1909. It shows the new 1910 model Moyer car taken in Washington Square. The 1910 Moyer car was built at the Moyer carriage factory while the automobile factory was being built. The 1910 Moyer extension tops Surrey. This photo shows Seymour Skiff's son Marshall in his father's 1910 Moyer car. The Skiffs were H.A. Moyer's good friends and next-door neighbor. Charles Esterbrook, H.A. Moyer's attorney since 1904, commissions Ward to build this house at 819 Comstock for his mother and stepfather, Theron Barnum. This is Ward's first house on the National Register of Historic Places, built in 1909 with a Dutch gambrel-style roof. This colonial revival also incorporates Tudor influences. Finished the last week of December 1909, the Moyer Automobile Factory is ready for production in 1910. The Moyer carriages are still in full demand, while the automobile is basically a toy for the rich. As the Moyer dynasty enters its last phase, the Ward dynasty enters its first. Built in 1910, Ward builds this colonial revival house, commissioned by Mrs. M.J. Malloy at 330 Farmer Street. Built for Mrs. Hamilton White, a Swiss-style chalet at 863 Lancaster Avenue.